CTJV Excavation Control Procedure. Excavation Work General Requirements. The most frequent excavation incidents, but not limited to, are due to the following causes: collapse of earthwork due to lack of inadequate shoring, persons falling into excavations due to lack of barriers or inadequate fencing, spoil from excavations not being kept clear of the sides, which then become overloaded and collapse, failure to maintain shoring, particularly after inclement weather, water seepage, persons working too close together, vehicles or plant machinery working too close to the edge, causing the edge to collapse, falls through unsafe means of access into or out of the excavation, workers being struck by excavating machinery, example, the bucket of the excavator, vehicles being driven into the excavation due to driving errors, inadequate barriers, or the absence of stop blocks or flagman, the striking of underground services, e.g. electricity cables and gas pipes, asphyxiation by different gases, e.g. H2S, CO2, exhaust gases, LPG vapor, etc., which have accumulated in the bottom of the excavation, asphyxiation by lack of oxygen due to inappropriate ventilation of the excavation, non-homogeneous or improperly compacted soil. Pre-work site inspection. Prior to excavation, the subcontractor will thoroughly inspect the site to determine what SHS measures must be taken. Underground utilities such as sewers, telephone, electric, water lines, or any other underground installations that may be encountered during excavation work will be physically located and marked. Excavation work with mobile equipment, such as backhoe, etc., shall cease when the work comes within 1.5 meter of any buried components. When excavating in the vicinity of underground services, excavation shall only be carried out in the full-time presence of the subcontractor supervisor in charge. In such a case, excavation shall be carried out manually using hand tools until the buried component is identified. When excavating to expose live cables, plastic-bladed shovels will be used to prevent damage to the cable insulation. As far as possible, live cables will be decommissioned during excavation. A scanner will be used to accurately determine the proximity of utilities prior to manual excavation to confirm the location of buried utilities. The location of identified services will be visibly marked on the surface in a manner that will last until the excavation is commenced. Utilities left in place will be protected by barricades, shoring, suspension, or other means as necessary. The subcontractor will implement controls to minimize potential risks and hazards associated with large open cut type excavations based on ground conditions. These controls will include specific information relating to ground control management. Subcontractor must immediately stop work and notify CTJV if any unexpected underground components are found or any underground components are accidentally damaged. A site inspection survey noting the proximity to other buildings, roads, structures, overhead hazards, example, overhead power lines, and natural surface drainage as part of the site data collection may be required. Soil classification. A geotechnical professional suitably experienced in the soil and rock slope design and construction or other competent person approved by CTJV will identify and classify the soil type for excavations where personnel have to enter. Type A means cohesive soils with an unconfined compressive strength of 1.5 ton per square foot, TSF, 144 kilopascals, or greater. Examples of cohesive soils are clay, silty clay, sandy clay, clay loam and, in some cases, silty clay loam and sandy clay loam. Cemented soils such as caliche and hardpan are also considered type A. However, no soil is type A if the soil is fissured, or the soil is subject to vibration from heavy traffic, pile driving, or similar effects, or the soil has been previously disturbed, or the soil is part of a sloped, layered system where the layers dip into the excavation on a slope of 4 horizontal to 1 vertical, for H, 1 V, or greater, or the material is subject to other factors that would require it to be classified as a less stable material. Type B means cohesive soil with an unconfined compressive strength greater than 0.5 TSF, 48 kPa, but less than 1.5 ton per square foot, TSF, 144 kPa, or granular cohesion less soils including angular gravel, similar to crushed rock, silt, silt loam, sandy loam and, in some cases, silty clay loam and sandy clay loam, previously disturbed soils except those which would otherwise be classified as type A soil. Soil that meets the unconfined compressive strength or cementation requirements for type A, but is fissured or subject to vibration, or dry rock that is not stable, or material that is part of a sloped, layered system where the layers dip into the excavation on a slope less steep than 4 horizontals to 1 vertical, for H, 1 V, but only if the material would otherwise be classified as type B. Type C means cohesive soil with an unconfined compressive strength of 0.5 TSF, 48 kPa, or less, or granular soils including gravel, sand, and loamy sand, or submerged soil or soil from which water is freely seeping, or submerged rock that is not stable, or material in a sloped, layered system where the layers dip into the excavation on a slope of 4 horizontal to 1 vertical, for H, 1 V, or steeper. Note, some locations may have different categories of soil types which will be assessed and classified by a geotechnical professional suitably experienced in the soil and rock slope design and construction. Rock types are not so simply classified, as the pattern of discontinuities and their orientation usually play a greater role in the stability of a rock face than the nature of the rock itself. Excavation protective systems, shoring trenching. Shoring provides effective and adequate temporary support for an exposed face of an excavation in soil. Shoring must be adequately designed in accordance with sound engineering practice and the materials used must be suitable and of sound quality to suit the depth of the excavation, the type of soil, and the nature of the work. Shoring type and trench lining equipment will be designed in accordance excavations. Specific slope design by an experienced geotechnical professional, use of stabilizing techniques such as anchors, removal of potentially unstable or metastable boulders, excavations greater than or equal to 4 feet 1.2 m deep are particularly hazardous and must be shored unless the face is cut back to a safe slope and the material in the face will remain stable under anticipated conditions of work and weather. Or, shoring is impracticable or unreasonable, and a geotechnical professional suitably experienced in the soil and rock slope design and construction or other competent person has certified that adequate precautions have been taken, or, no one will be entering the excavation. Excavations shallower than 4 feet 1.2 m can still collapse. Protection of personnel in excavations shallower than 4 feet 1.2 m will also be provided where hazardous ground movement may be expected or where the activities to be conducted in the trench requires the workers to crouch down. Sloping benching. Sloping may be substituted for shoring. The slope will be at least 1.5 m horizontal to 1 m vertical, 34 degrees measured from horizontal, unless the instability of the soil requires a flatter slope as determined by a geotechnical professional suitably experienced in the soil and rock slope design and construction. A slope steeper than 1.5 m horizontal to 1 m vertical may be used, where a geotechnical professional suitably experienced in the soil and rock slope design and construction has assessed the soil conditions and issued an engineer's certificate, certified engineering drawing or report, for the steeper slope. Excavation and penetration hazard controls. Access egress. Any excavation requiring personnel entry will be provided with safe means of access and egress every 25 feet 6.2 m of horizontal travel when the excavation is deeper than 1.2 m. For big excavations, at least two access egress points shall be provided at opposite points. Rescue situations shall be taken into account. Surface crossings of trenches will be avoided where possible. Where personnel are required to cross trenches, properly designed walkways or bridges will be provided with guardrails and kickboards. Portable ladders must properly be secured and extend at least 1 m above the surface of the excavation or intermediate landing. Workers will not use the components of a shoring system as a means of entering or leaving an excavation. Where there is a risk that persons could fall from the edge or face, edge protection consisting of a fall protection, or alternatively guard railing consisting of a top rail, mid rail, and toe board must be provided. Persons will not enter an excavation while heavy equipment is in use or mechanical digging is taking place. Barricades. Personnel will be protected from accidental falls into excavations. Excavations will be provided with hard barricade, clear signage, and the details of the excavation owner, supervisor's name, and contact details displayed. Barriers will also be a warning for vehicles or equipment being located too close to any excavation. Traffic management. Prior to commencement of excavations affecting roads or traffic movement, a documented traffic management plan will be prepared that includes, where necessary, traffic controller, barricades, and any road closures. The traffic management plan will be approved by the CTJV construction manager or delegate and be made available at the worksite at all times when work is carried out. Traffic management plans will be communicated at the start of the shift to all personnel affected. The excavation area will be isolated from access by vehicles not involved in the excavation work. Mobile equipment. A warning system will be used when mobile equipment is operated adjacent to the edge of an excavation if the operator does not have a clear and direct view of the edge of the excavation. The warning system will consist of barricades, hand or mechanical signals. If possible, the grade will be away from the excavation. Mobile plant, vehicles, or any heavy loads must not approach closer than 1.5 m from the edge of the excavation. The advice of a suitably experienced geotechnical professional will be sought if it is required to take mobile equipment towards the edge of an excavation. The distance requiring geotechnical advice will be equal or lesser than the depth of excavation.